Hello everyone, I'm CM Dragonlark.
And I'm Ciamota.
And this is our weekly Dragon Saga Let's Play live stream. Today, right now, we're in Milky Way Sanctuary, I believe.
I've moved on to Dangerous
already.
Caverns.
It's been like a minute and he's already abandoned me.
You know, you gotta move fast in Dragon Saga.
Oh my gosh. So we're heading on to Dangerous Caverns.
Yeah.
So you could join us in-game if you'd like.
Yeah, we're going to be doing some of the hero quests here.
Yeah, we've been focusing on that. And yeah, so this is exciting. I've never been in Dangerous Caverns before.
Oh. This will be an adventure.
Quests are happening.
Oh, okay.
Things are happening. Oh my gosh, look at the cute little spark monsters. Oh, I should tell my monster. Oh no,
ooh,
things that knock you over.
A lot of knockdowns here. I mean, not even that they're doing a ton of damage, but... I wonder what it is that has a knockdown effect.
It's always good to know that ahead of time so I can
glare
at them while I'm fighting them. Don't you dare. Oh, I like the designs on the monsters in here. I always say that when I get to a new area, but I really like the design on these monsters.
They're kind of like...
Looks like
they're wearing, like, Mexican wrestler masks.
Is that...
Yeah, I think so.
What a coincidence. Is it really...
Oh, bad? You had a quest to talk to Jeff?
Yes. Do you not...
Do you remember what...
It may be.
You know what? I may not have gotten that one yet. That's fine. That's fine.
This
that's
was
fine.
Your idea.
Oh, boy. All right, here we go. Well, I can talk to the wounded backup Muriel.
I'll get this one. I think I could talk to them, too. Yeah. No.
Yeah, they're
I can. Oh, they look so sad. Oh, my God.
Are you from Fellowship? The Dragon Lord must have sent you to me. Yes. Can you help me, please? I'm the supply soldier that supplies the Laura camp, but I got attacked all of a sudden since it happened so fast. It was so dark, I don't know who made attack.
I mean...
Can you slay all the monsters around here?
Every single one of them.
We can and will. Fist doo-doo.
But they look so happy. I don't believe them. He's probably like a bad guy or something.
So, these things, I don't know what... Like, they kind of have lizard characteristics. You know what? Maybe they're like, whatchamacallits?
Like the candy?
You know how there's the, they're kind of like... They have platypus. Yeah, that's it.
There is no way from that description.
Yeah, you know, it's the thing. Yeah, didn't you know? Alright, I need to get rid of some of these misc items.
I'm actually really close to playing the inventory game myself. I logged in and I was
oh no. So am I.
Is this a dude's toenail? Oh, that is toenail.
Dude's toenail.
Even if it's not that.
Consumables, alright.
Oh, these are moles, like...
Oh, okay. Full, huh?
Oh, no. Does that mean what I think it means? It does! You're playing the inventory game. Meanwhile, I'll just murder all these things. So you've played a couple of Dragon Saga type characters now, right?
Yeah.
What is your favorite so far?
I kind of like what I played of the archer and sort of having sort of partied up with a lot of archers. There are a lot of really cool abilities that they have.
Yeah. I'm really excited to get higher level with some of those too that I've seen on the tree. He's got one more. But I'm gonna keep doing it. Oh my god, their animation when they come up from underground is super cute. I feel really bad murdering them. Ah. They're just like looking around like, hey, what's
no.
up? What happened?
I really have no room.
Hey, Popcorn. How's it going?
What do I have? I guess I can use nutrition pills.
Just throw things away. It's okay.
Yeah, because I'm trying to get rid of my misc, and then they're just all turning into consumables. So it's like, oh.
I actually learned a lesson. I moved this morning, and it's like you don't realize how much stuff you accumulate, even in like real life.
Mm-hmm.
Until suddenly you have to fit everything into one car.
Oh my goodness.
And then it's like, okay, what can I buy again? What is invaluable and what can be repurchased in the future?
Mm-hmm.
Have I seen, even if I like something, if I'm like, I haven't used this in like a couple months, I probably don't need it, so don't even look at it, just throw it away.
There's supposed to be a rule of thumb for like, oh, you know, you haven't used this in this amount of time, you know, you probably toss it out.
I have trouble tossing books. Like, hey, Razul.
Hey, how are you doing? Hey, we're back into the skeletons.
Yeah. They're so happy. Right before they, you know, are murdered, I guess. They were just sitting here minding their own business, attacking me, and we came across their path.
Oh, that mage, some strong skills.
What mage?
Ooh.
Oh. The person here.
Yeah, you know, they generate kind of like the spiky stuff by him.
Did you complete your quest?
Yeah, suppression of monsters. Let's get that completed. Yeah, I see some monsters around here, but I can still hide myself without any trouble. So let's...
find what the next quest is. Oh, there it is. Just kidding. I found it. Find the offender first. Is that the one you're on now? Shroom assassin? What is a shroom assassin?
It's exactly how it sounds.
I don't...
I guess I still have some quests for the underground caverns, but that's not.
I also have quests for the underground caverns.
I've got Sen's escape. I need to talk to Sen. So I think Sen is back the way we came. So I'll make my way back over there.
In Dangerous Caverns?
Yeah, he's where those other NPCs were. Hey there, Popcorn. How are you doing?
Hey, Monitor Cable.
Okay.
Alright, is this the person? You're running into a wall on my screen. Oh, that's not... You were talking to this person. Oh, that's another person who's running into the wall. I didn't have a quest to talk to.
Let's see what Ferguson has. Ah, yes. Shroom meat from Shroom.
That's a Lira. Let's get that one up.
You see the guy in the corner who's shaking? I want to help him out. He's making me nervous. He needs to calm down. Please enter Dangerous Caverns arcade mode F1 and defeat Shroom. Bring back 15 Shroom meat.
Oh, make him a soup to help him. It's mission time.
Yeah. Alright, so I'm guessing it's just at the top of the cavern.
No, should we be going this way then? If we're going to the top of the cavern, shouldn't we be going over here?
Oh, look at that. That's a cool looking map. Are talking about the mining area, maybe? I mean, there's some shrooms here.
I don't have the question mark over them. Here. Well, let's see. Oh. Whoa. No.
That's just like another...
It's another area. I think it's over here.
Where? To the...
This.
Oh, okay.
Actually, and we could go... We can take the shortcut. Actually.
Okay.
It wants us to go... So we're going to try hardwood. That's what it told me to do.
Okay.
That'll be fine.
Recommended.
Thank you. Okay. Yeah. We learned that the hard way.
Okay, little boxes. All right, so we are on a timer here.
Dragons. There are dragons in here.
Oh
no, look, there's dragons.
Oh, yeah, look at that.
So cute.
Do they have pets for the red dong dong?
It looks like a dragon.
Yeah, I think it's a dragon.
That is awesome.
Oh, yeah, there's a ranking here, so better, use the skills.
They look like dragons, and you can't stop me from calling them dragons.
No, it's fine, they're dragons.
No, popcorn's arguing.
Uh-oh.
No, they're dragons.
Well, it's a dong-dong, so, you know, it's, you know what, maybe that, does that mean dragon in...
No.
Russian? Because in Japan, it's Ryu. But,
Wait, how is it? How do you say dragon?
Ryu. R-Y-U. And I think it's like with a longer U.
Interesting.
Ryu. But it's kind of like in The Legend of Zelda, the sort of like dragony, turtley monsters were called Dodongo. So I wonder if, like, there's a similar root word for, like, dragon.
I have no idea. If anyone else does, please let us know.
Yeah, these are very dragon-like. Their beaks are not...
Yeah.
Yeah. But, I mean, you know, if it's 80% dragon, I mean, you know. I mean, there's not a lot else that these could be unless they're, like, leathery parrots.
I know, that's what it looks. Which I mean,
would be a pretty cool pet, don't get me wrong. This leathery parrot is deceased! It is no more!
Is that from something?
Yeah.
That was gonna be my guess. Because it did sound like a very,
British.
Mighty Python. Well, just that particularly Mighty Python, like, skits use that high-pitched, like,
yes, it,
tone for things.
It's not used in common English very much. Hello, Mrs. Non-Gorilla!
I think the only one of those movies I saw all the way through was the Holy Grail one.
Oh, yeah, it's fantastic. It's kind of like a nice framework. Whoa.
These shroom things are scary looking.
It's got teeth.
Terrifying.
Well, I'm getting stuff in my quest, that's for sure. Well, that's not enough room in inventory!
Oh no, this is the worst time to play the inventory game.
No.
Oh my gosh, these cute little creatures have pumpkins on their heads.
Alright, I'm just gonna throw out this copper ore.
Okay.
Sorry, copper ore. I guess I'm not going to be needing you. Doodoo's toenail. Shark tooth. Oh.
We're running out of time.
You're right. Okay, so you got the gray. No, I guess he seems just have regular dragon type mouths. Well, we're doing very well here.
Yeah, it might be good if we took some time before the live stream every day to clean out our inventory.
Yeah, yeah.
But then it wouldn't be as exciting. There wouldn't be these moments of wonder,
you know,
and fear.
We're good at the combat, but inventory, that's what gets us.
That's the true challenge of dragons. These look like dragons. These look like dragons.
Yeah, these are much more dragony.
I mean, I guess you'd call it something else in the sense that, like, you can differentiate between different kinds of dragons.
Yeah, well,
like,
it's like a drake.
Like, oh, I'm
or...
actually in inventory too.
Yeah, see that. There
I
you
have
go.
Also found, but I knew before I started. I just.
Oh, come on, I have you. It's okay. We got 5 minutes. That's not too bad. There we go. Here's some of the quest monsters. Okay, now we're getting the shroom meat. 2 out of 15.
Oh, I don't have anything in my this here. All right, I got it. Random things. No, I like that little thing even though I can't use it. It's so cute. Alright, here. I'm gonna have to do this again because I was not picking up the quest items because there wasn't room in my inventory.
Same here.
Was a much worse inventory
here.
Game mistake.
When you play the inventory
this
game.
Reminds me of the Lord of the Rings scene.
Yeah. You know,
like,
you shout out.
Yeah,
that.
Exactly.
The Bindings of Moria.
No. That would be cool if that happened right now, but I bet it's not.
There's a, was it a basilisk? What was, oh, Balrog, yeah.
Yeah.
That
was like a basilisk or something, snake.
See, look at that. You're born to be a GM or a DM.
I have a book at that I now I know what all my books are because I had to look through them all and decide which ones were worthy of survival. But
okay.
I have a book that's like just about like different kind of like magical creature like lore, and it's like
ooh.
Huge.
Yeah.
And I was
go.
Like, I could probably find this information on the internet, but I'm not gonna get rid of this book. But I used to just read through it, and every day I'd, like, try to memorize one of them.
Yeah, I think this thing is just, like, a weird platypus or something.
Which thing?
The doo-doos.
They look like, moles.
Hey, but they can be knocked into the air, which is cool.
They don't look...
A mean, lot of boss monsters won't let you do that.
Yeah. They're like, I think not.
Ooh.
I'm gonna stick out these little guys while you work on the. You got this, it's fine.
Ooh. He's not happy. He is not a happy camper.
He's a little grumpy about something.
I like it though. There's a lot of positioning stuff that you kind of have to do. Like, you know.
That is a mask. Oops. Oh, I've fallen.
and you cannot get up.
Well, that would really suck. I hate it. Actually, that's like the worst, you know, when something like makes you fall and then...
And then you keep getting hit.
Yeah. It's like, ah! Just one shot.
Oh yeah, that was definitely one you didn't want to get hit with. Nice. I hit him with a hammer and they died. Atu rookie. Atu, what kind of mess have you gotten this into? Not enough room, man.
Well, what? There's plenty of room in everyone's inventory forever. Did we get triple S? We did! We're awesome!
Time to play the inventory game once we get those new items in there,
Oh, this isn't gear I can use. Did you get any archer gear? You did! Can I have your archer gear?
Okay. Hey, I got pauldrons. Nice.
What is that? Archer king's armor? That sounds cool.
Okay.
So, we need to go back in here because I need the stupid list items still. I failed so badly. What's over here? I'm gonna go up here. Oh, these guys are out here too.
Okay, so you needed the archer thing? I was going
towards the mission entrance I got. Because we were, I think, in different places on the map.
Yeah.
Oh, that's such a cool, Oh, someone has the Midnight Scream pet.
The Midnight what?
Midnight Scream. It's,
Scream.
Yeah. Oh, you're almost there.
Yeah, I'm almost there.
Oh, what's in my inventory? Ah, so many things. Okay. Get rid of some stuff.
Can you request some trade?
Let's see if I have anything.
And
but you're a knight? Or no, you're a gladiator?
Mm-hmm.
Here, you could have this thing. I don't know if it's actually good for you or not, but
I probably have lots of archer stuff.
And I just realized that maybe we should be like I have a knight thing and I have a Yeah, but you're not a knight, right? You're a guardian? Or a gladiator?
Yes.
Okay.
Yeah, some of this stuff is like, oh, level 20 armor, and it's like, nah, I don't really need that stuff. Oh yeah, that's much better.
Woohoo! We should have been doing this before.
Yeah, you may have something there.
Because I realize like a lot of times we go into the dungeons and I'll get something I can't use. And it's you can just trade it.
I hate that we have the stuff we can't use, and it's like, there was a solution to that all the time.
Alright. Yes, that's fine. The assassins can be found left and right on the path. Alright, well
Okay, so in the mining area, they have some of the mage doo-doos that we gotta get. Or at least I gotta get.
Apparently we can find the assassins, like, around here, too, so we don't have to go back in there.
Oh, perfect.
Assassins. Yeah. Thank you for the help, Mondra Cable. I know, my inventory is clear. Just this part. It's this. Things I technically don't need. I don't want this guy's toenail.
Oh, you're selling it? Oh, that's a good idea.
I'm just throwing things away. I guess I can.
Oh, you're throwing things away.
That's this quest item
on? Well, let's see if Edward the Jewel Merchant.
I'm sure quest items can be obtained again.
I don't know if I have any jewels that I can buy. Stuff is kind of nice. Where do you get jewels?
Jewels?
Yeah.
What kind of jewels?
Like, Edward is a jewel merchant.
What does a jewel? Oh. You get a low chance for getting them from the
Edward. Oh, okay.
For all missions.
All right.
So I know I've gotten jewels. I sell stuff for him? I don't think I can.
No, I think the merchants are kind of in that original in that area now. So, you know what? Let me... I do need to get that stuff cleared out so I can...
Alright. Where are you going to go? Back to that?
Yeah.
Alright. I guess I'll do that too. We'll sell stuff. I feel bad, like, just jumping over these guys and kill them.
It's okay, you know. You'll get to them eventually. Alright, yeah, let's talk to the merchants here.
Can I go down here?
Ooh, what's this? Street vendor. Ah, that's nice.
I love my little sushi following me around, too.
Mm-hmm.
Alright, alrighty, all the things that I probably need to get through that too. What can I throw away?
The Defense Order, Skypie Sanctuary, should I hang on to those? I've got a lot of like Hidden Scroll, Prison Scroll, got a coin, of course, you gotta keep. Chocolate Pie Recipe, Ice Laboratory Garden Ticket, Chaos Scroll. I'm kind of outside of the range for that.
Yeah, maybe. Maybe you should. I don't actually know for sure, but I mean, I think you should follow what you want to do. Some items I keep unnecessarily because I like how I look.
How about keys?
So. Oh, okay.
Are those worth keeping or?
Have you used them? Are they like keys for chests? Because then you might want to.
Yeah, mysterious treasure box. Oh, okay. Can't be sold.
I'm okay for now, I think. Except for this section. Inventory game. Alright.
Armor enchant dust cube.
Oh yeah, I have a bunch of the defense orders too.
How about nutrition pills? Are those really worth hanging out to?
No, I thought it was all right.
Oh, can't be sold. Cool. Well, you know what? Now I'm just throwing them on the ground.
Oh.
Rest in peace. Let's you rest in peace for a while. Protect the character for 20 minutes. I don't know what that even does.
Alright.
Ticket to Chocolate Meister's house? I guess we don't even really need that anymore.
Yeah.
Take that.
I'm gonna make this. I'm gonna cancel it. So I'm gonna get rid of it. Interesting. Cool. I'm never gonna use that.
Huh. I've got 6 sapphires.
Rest in peace. Is that the nickname for Otis' pet, Peko Peko?
Yes, it is. It is now.
It definitely should.
It definitely
be.
Is now.
So sad.
Job advancement report. Let's hang on to that. White cherry blossom petal. I think that was for the cherry blossom event. I don't think we need that anymore, right?
I guess not. I don't want to let go of it. It says the word quest item on it.
Vintage yogurt.
Poor Peko.
Yeah, I don't...
Actually the first thing I did while I was, I gave food to my griffin. I was like, you know, little buddy.
Oh, wow, very nice. Orcish voucher, plain bark, hard shell.
You're being much more meticulous. I think you have more inventory space than I do.
I think somebody gave me a nice, like, hey, you know.
I want to click on this and see what it does. I'm going to do it. Haha! This was like a super unnecessary place to use this, but I wanted to see what it did. And I didn't want to take up space in my inventory because I was just going to hold on to it forever. That's cool.
Alright. Are you crafting things?
Yeah!
No!
That's part of
No! No.
I mean, that's what people are.
You're just gonna have to throw it away.
No, I'm eating them. Don't worry. Kind of.
No, you're not using.
You just threw away a bunch of them. Which ones are you crafting? Look at those defense armor things.
You guys can't see. He has so many of them. They come in handy from time.
Have you ever used them? Ever? Have you ever used them?
Yeah, sometimes. No. Sometimes I'll remember.
Oh, God. Come on, Santa, go kill mushrooms.
Okay, I can replace 7 with this. So I'll... Yeah, I think that's what I gotta do. I just have to replace some of these...
He has so many things. Your inventory would actually be pretty, like, clean if you got rid of some of that stuff.
Yeah, you know what? I'm just gonna... What I need to do is just bind this stuff to my keys.
Yes. And then use them at every opportunity so they're gone.
Yep. And I gotta do more crafting.
You don't have to do more crafting. Now is not the time for crafting. Yeah. Now is the time for mushroom murder.
Okay, all right. Let's go and murder some mushrooms. But I like getting the bar in right in the middle. That's one of my favorite. Uh-oh. Temp inventory. I better start eating these.
Wait, how do you... How do you still have stuff in here? Do you still... How?
It's okay, I just need to...
That inventory tab is literally full.
No,
that's where you put your quest items.
Where are you right now? You're just we're
just
gonna head back.
I'm hovering over here.
We gotta head back into the mining area, right?
Oh no, we have to still kill the assassins. Still, I need to kill the assassins still at least because my inventory was full.
It's fine, Corbala. It's not that bad.
It's bad. He still has one tab that's full.
It's like, but,
he
you know,
stopped
I'm,
clearing his inventory to create
might,
more items.
I might need these, you know.
The goal was to clear your inventory out, and you created more items instead. That's what happened.
I created more consumable items. I turned items that I cannot eat into ones that I love to eat.
No.
There's some shroom assassins around here.
Yes. So you can murder them. I'm shooting at nothing.
I wonder if I have that quest.
This one's just kind
of
sitting.
You know what
here.
The name of what is the name of the quest?
For the shroom assassins?
Yeah.
Find out the offending something. I can't see the rest of it.
Is it regular or hero?
Hero. Huh. It was from that first guy we talked to.
That's weird.
Oh no, the guy who was like scared and like dying and wanted us to save him. Which of his quests do you have right now?
I don't think I have any left. I just have the ones that are, I need to get the mage.
Let me see what level it's. Oh, it's level It's no, it's a little here. Let's see if I can share. You are an oh, because level 39.
Oh.
All right. So what do you have to do right now? Then we can go do that.
Got the quest. The Joyce Pirates in the mining area. Let me see if I can share it.
Oh, they're throwing mushrooms.
Unable to accept because the quests in progress are full.
Oops, okay, here. Okay. I'll get rid of one of these things. Oh, I do have the secret of Joyce Pirates. Just kidding.
Okay, so yeah, we just need to keep going to the west and then north.
She looks really funny when she does the twirl thing. Because she has like the little like funny nose. Am I going the right way? Okay. I was like,
Yeah. Okay, we're heading into the mining area, level 37, they say. Okay, got some of the quest launchers here. Okay.
Oh, I really love the art for these, like, fire dudes. They're super cute. See every single area.
Dragon Saga has some fantastic monster areas that you... Those very iconic designs.
Yeah. It's awesome. All right. Going this way? We are going this way. It looks like there's poison here.
Oh, you mean like the ground? There's kind of like a little fog on the ground? Yeah, I can definitely see that.
Okay, so, oh, I shouldn't say that. People are going to post spoilers. I mean, it doesn't matter to me because I've already seen it, but... Are you planning on seeing the new Captain America movie?
Yeah, I might actually see that this week. Yeah, definitely looking forward to seeing it. Like, as far as spoilers go, like, you know, I'm not a big comic book guy, so I kind of don't know. Like, well, I don't know if there's anything really that can be like, oh, they found the crystal of Gahul. You know, that's the guardian owls were protecting it, and
I promise that doesn't happen in the movie. Spoiler alert.
You know, and then they discover, of course, that. You know, Bucky Barnes is actually the reincarnation of the owner of Earth, and you know they have to go inside of Jupiter to. Right, the scheming children of Bucky Barnes.
Captain America to that terrible movie.
You know, but bees, they recognize royalties.
Unforgivable.
It's like, oh, I like dogs.
That was like the worst movie.
We need to have like a podcast or something where we talk about this.
He's level 38. Because
like Campator and I, like he looked to be in pain while he was watching the movie, but I was just like, he's like, hey, let's see this movie. I was like, yeah, okay.
Oh, it was terrible.
But I was smiling the whole time.
Of course you were. Why though? Why?
For me, it was just, like, so goofy. Like, I kind of had a...
It was, like, taking itself so seriously.
Yeah, that was like, the weird thing about it.
If they were just like, oh, we're being ridiculous, but they were just, like, they were being serious. It wasn't like a...
They thought that they were... Well, I don't know. I mean, science, sci-fi Cinderella is... It's not a bad idea. Like, you could
Isn't. I won't even say the idea was bad. The execution was awful. I was excited about the movie, and then I watched it, and I was like, what is happening? happening? Why is there a 10-minute space DMV scene? That's the part that like, really, I think I almost... There were so many bad things, and I'm always just, like, trying to be like, it's okay. And then I'll just,
there,
like,
are a lot of baffling decisions. Like, you know what? That's one of the reasons why I was smiling, is because sometimes when you are faced with a situation that you cannot understand or control, you just have to just smile. It's like, what's going on? Help me! Why is he skating in the sky?
Logic. Did you get all the figs here, by the way? I think I completed this quest.
I'm having fun here talking about Jupiter setting in okay. theaters now.
It's not, and thank God for that.
It's like, sometimes you watch a movie and you understand instinctually that it's like the definition of ill-conceived. It's just sort of like, I guess you did say, like, it's not that it wouldn't work. Like, the concepts are not the worst, but the execution...
Everything about the execution was terrible. Like, everything. Hey, Pre-Crush!
Hey, Pre-Crush, how are you doing? Yeah, I don't know. Maybe it's just like, I haven't... It was tough for me because Mila Kunis, like, I'm not even a Family Guy fan, but whenever she talks, it's just like, oh, that you're that character.
I never watched Family Guy, so I never have that problem. Today's update, we have the patch notes up.
Ooh.
I know Pre-Crush was going through update withdrawals because of the server restart and not having... patch notes, but there's patch notes up right now. The Griffin for President event is going to be ending today, and there's going to be a new
Spectre's Tower
daily quest event. So definitely, yeah, the Woody chair. Check it out if you haven't yet. Although it looks like everyone has, mm-hmm. because there's going to be some fun stuff being added.
Okay, so Shroom Thieves. I guess it's just in that, in the dangerous, well, it says at culverts. So what does that mean? That's like,
well,
I think that's one of the areas. All right, so
we have to go back to dangerous.
Yeah,
caverns.
I think we got to go back to the DC, as I like to say.
As you like to say.
Yes.
Yeah.
Ah. What's that about? Woody chair?
Yeah, that's with the update today. Is you're going to be able to get Woody chairs and, like, a stall with, like, Woody chair.
For your house? For your
well,
my home?
Well, the stall
or?
You can...
Oh, no, for a shop.
Yeah.
Oh, cool. Okay, so we got to get all the way to the east, and then we'll head up north. Oh, I like these little pumpkin head guys. That's cute.
That
They're like little moles or little mice or something. They have pumpkin head hats.
I think they're like little.
Kind of bailed on that one. You're like, yeah.
I was about to say like it was something, and then I realized I don't know what it is. Oh no, this isn't the right way to go.
Oh no, you're right.
I was going this way like this path was going to end. That's not true. I was mindlessly following you. That's what happened.
Yeah,
led us astray.
Oh, well, it's okay. No, we can jump down here and then at the bottom, at the west of here, we can get onto the jump pad.
You shall not pass. There's like the smaller version of it, so it's not impressive.
Whoa, what's this?
Oh, a summoner. Oh, maybe.
That's a cool looking summon.
One of these days we'll get back on our dragonkin. But not today.
And I think I still have like a really low level archer too.
Well, wasn't that the one that we did with the long play?
Oh, yeah, you know, that's probably true.
So we'll definitely get back to that. And like, I think that was, oh, I went through here.
I like the long plays a lot because, you know, sort of like, we don't play a ton of like the other, like the games that we don't manage, you know, that kind of stuff.
Mm-hmm.
Oh yeah, the barrel bones can definitely knock you down.
Run away! Abandon Oda! Just kidding, sort of. Did you get back up?
Yeah. Okay, so we just need to get into that culverts area.
Ah, something immediately started attacking me!
But yeah, I mean, you know, I'm a fan of bad movies.
I actually really like terrible movies, but I like the monster movies that are really bad.
Oh, like what?
Mega Shark versus Giant Octopus. I've watched that movie like 12 times.
Okay, I mean, you know,
the Anaconda movies were pretty ridiculous. I used to watch the sci-fi movies.
Oh boy.
Oh my god, there was that, like, what was it? I think there was a movie about piranhas that came out recently that was so bad. Like, at one point, and it's in the preview.
Was it Piranha 3D?
Maybe. It was... I don't think the one I'm thinking of was in theaters, because there was one that was, like, in theaters or something.
They're like, yeah, wow. This one didn't go to theaters.
No, there was a really... This one definitely didn't... Well, I mean, there was, in the preview for the movie, like, it shows someone bicycle kicking the piranhas. Like,
yeah, there we go.
That was amazing. I was like, this is so dumb. I love it. All the Sharknado movies. Actually, I haven't actually watched the Sharknado movies all the way.
In general, it has to be really good if it's a intentionally bad movie. Because I don't know. For me, like, I love movies where, they didn't know it was going to be bad. Like, that's why...
That's sad to me.
You know, growing up with Mystery Science Theater, it's like, even though it is sad to just be making fun of a movie that somebody thought would be really good, you know, I think there's still something that you can be learned, that can be learned from that. Like, I guess there's a difference between, like, you know, we tried really hard, but, you know, it just didn't come together. Like, that's not as much fun as, like, this guy thought this was going to be Citizen Kane, but they, you know, like, the Room is fascinating to me because it's a...
The Room. Which one's that?
That's the one with kind of the, oh, hi, Mark, you know, oh, hi, Denny.
I don't know what that is.
It's a weird movie because it is like, it is a weirdly kind of personal movie. Like, it's like, oh, there's this really good guy named Johnny, and he thinks he's doing an American accent, but not happening.
Wander Cable, there's gonna be a long play on Friday. And I don't, what is this week again?
Requiem?
Requiem. Yeah. It'll be a Requiem long play.
But yeah, he wanted to make, like, Rebel Without a Cause. But, you know, it's kind of like this movie made by this, like, honestly, really interesting, strange guy.
I've never heard that. I mean, I think I've heard of a movie called Room, but I don't think it's the one you're referring to.
Yeah, The Room is kind of like, it's one of the most infamous new bad movies. It's like they have people who watch it in the theater, and it's like the Rocky Horror Picture Show where they'll say the lines and, like, there's a scene where they just have a, it's a framed picture with a spoon on the wall.
What? Why?
It's just like a picture of a spoon, and so everybody yells spoon when it comes on screen, and they throw plastic spoons at the screen. So it's kind of like a weird audience participation thing.
I've never heard of this.
The Room, it's a fascinating movie. Because it's obvious that it's, like, very personal. It's like, oh, you know, there's this really good guy named Johnny, and, you know, he's about to get married to his fiance, but, you know, his fiance doesn't really like him and is cheating on him and stuff like that.
What?
yeah, I mean, it's this, like, relationship drama movie, but it's just very bizarrely acted. There are actors who, like, It was basically filmed on the weekends. It's just like the actors, they'd come in over the weekends, but the movie took so long that there are some characters that appear in the movie that aren't in the later parts of the movie.
Oh, God.
Because they just, like, left the production. You know, and...
That's awful.
You know, he's kind of, like, difficult to work with, and,
That does not sound entertaining to watch at all. I'm sorry. That sounds...
You know, it is one of those things where maybe that is, like, a weird acquired taste.
I mean, it's obvious if there's, like, large groups of people going to it that it's, It's something that some people really enjoy, so that's good. But I think I'm more just... I just like the monsters. I like watching monsters.
Yeah, I mean... I'm also a big fan of Neil Breen.
Okay.
He's a... I think he's like an architect or something in Nevada who lives near Vegas, who makes these movies where he's like the smartest man in the world. And sometimes he has psychic powers. He hacks the entire government.
What?
He's kind of like, no one's sure if he's like kind of a crazy guy, but his movies are mind bending.
Man, I thought I was, like, somewhat movie savvy. I have no idea what these movies are that you're referring to. Like, I've never heard of them.
You gotta... It's deep internet. When you get into the deep internet, you know, it's...
I mean, are these movies that appeared in movie theaters at some point?
Oh, no. this movie... I mean, the movies of Neil Breen are all on, like, YouTube.
Oh.
But not because he put them there. Like,
oh, no.
It used to be that you'd have to, like... you would have to send him an email to sell it to you.
What?
These are like weird rinky-dink operations. Like, it's just like, he's an amateur filmmaker who...
I thought you were referring to like an actual movie. It's like someone who makes you email them for the money.
Yeah.
It's
like, yeah, I sent him $10 for a DVD and it just didn't come.
Oh my god.
But... the people who did get the DVD loved it, and they are on YouTube now.
Wait, so you tried to get it, and it really didn't come?
No, some other people had that issue.
Oh, that's awful.
Okay, Dangerous Caverns, Caligon. Looking for Upset Sparks and Upset Mutant Sparks in the mining areas. It's like, hey, gotta go back to the mining area.
Okay. I am on my way, maybe. I don't know where I am. I just kept going in a direction, and then...
Shana Roy, the Tiki Tuesday live stream archive, that is... that is on YouTube.
Oh, these are right here.
Okay, so I'm heading back to Dangerous Caverns from the Culverts.
Okay, yeah, I'm Dangerous Caverns. Yeah, I think when you said you liked bad movies, I was a different kind of bad, I think. There are different levels of bad. There are many different types of bad, I think.
I mean, like, films like Godzilla and stuff like that, or... I mean, the original Godzilla is not a B-movie.
Oh, I liked the, what was the... It wasn't the Godzilla 2000, I don't think. It was the one where there were, like, little baby Godzillas. It was really bad. Like, a lot of people thought it was really
yeah,
bad.
Godzilla 1998, I believe?
It was something like that. I just liked the Godzilla monsters, like... Because I like that they look like dinosaurs, and I remember I just really enjoyed just... I don't remember anything about that movie except for the fact that there was little baby Godzilla monsters running around it. I was so excited about there being dinosaurs.
Yeah, Hank Azaria drives a... Hank Azaria, the voice of Mo on The Simpsons and a bunch of other characters.
Oh my god, really?
The Godzilla movie has more Simpsons actors than any movie except for The Simpsons movie.
That is fantastic.
It's like Nancy Cartwright was in the voice of Bart. She was in a scene in a news office where she says, "Sir, yeah, sir, the it looks like your story is walking outside the window. You know, your big story." Yardley Smith, I don't know if she was in there, but Yardley Smith was in Maximum Overdrive, which was a Stephen King film. Have you seen that?
I haven't. Is that one of the car ones?
Yeah, that's one of the...
The fact that he has more than one car one.
Oh, kind of. Stephen King is rotten with remaking movies that he's already kind of done.
Well, no, I mean, even books. Like, Maximum, those are different books, right? Because there was Christine, which is...
Yeah, it's like, listen...
And then he had Maximum Overdrive, which was like a... Was that a short story?
Yeah.
But how can you have more than one scary story about a demon car? Like...
Oh, he made it happen.
He did, but why?
I
love Stephen King. I love his movies. There is
a real answer to that, and Stephen King has said it himself. And he was on some drugs when he made and wrote Maximum Overdrive.
Yeah. But what if the car was trying to kill me?
Well, it's like, I mean, killer car is pretty cool, but what if it was like a killer semi-truck?
Oh, yeah, Maximum Overdrive has the truck, right? Christine is just a car.
Maximum Overdrive.
Just a car.
It's weird because they, like, escape on a boat, and wouldn't boats also be evil?
I mean, is this a world where all of the vehicles have turned?
Well,
like,
it's really inconsistent because there's the, like, vending machine in the beginning of the movie that shoots Coke cans.
How did I miss a movie where the vending machine is attacking
people? It murders a guy by just shooting Coke cans at him.
That sounds amazing.
Like,
I need to watch this.
He's like, "Whoa, what's going on here?" And then he puts his face right next to where the cans shoot out, and it shoots out and hits him right and beans him right in the head.
And he dies.
Well, I don't know if that's... there's also one where, like, a lawnmower gets a guy. Like, it's all in the beginning of it. It's a really goofy movie. But that one... To get back to Godzilla 1998, that... Oh, boy. Yeah, it has Hank Azaria as the New York cab driver. It has Harry Shearer, the voice of Kent Brockman, and he plays a news reporter in Godzilla.
That's interesting. I have to rewatch. Again, I don't remember anything except for the dinosaurs. I love the dinosaur Godzilla monster.
It's horrible. You know, I have a photographic memory, but only for bad movies. So it's like, well, that's a talent that is not useful at all. I can remember every aspect of these worst movies in the world.
What's
cool.
This?
That's my life.
I got a copy. I don't know.
I don't really have any new quests here. Skypey Sanctuary, I got one.
Do you don't have any new quests?
I've got a few in Parmer. Parmer Sanctuary.
Here, let me try to share this with you.
Sure.
Oh, we're on different maps.
Oh. Where are you right now? You're in Dangerous Caverns?
Yes.
Okay, let me go back there. Yeah, maybe we can finish this off and then...
Do you have you don't have any of the Tomb Raider quests? Oh, maybe you should see if you can...
Oh.
Pick up the new one. Okay.
No good?
No.
Maybe I'm not high enough level yet.
It's level 37.
Huh. Do I need to ditch some quests?
It doesn't say
that.
Oh,
what's this?
Oh, you're floating off into space. That's what. Bad movies like Food Fight and Cash and Tango. I have no idea what that is. I don't know what just happened.
You said the magic word, Corbala. You said Food Fight.
What does that mean?
I think, Dragonlark, you need to go and bring up a YouTube window.
No.
With Food Fight
in
there.
No, I'm scared. I'm not doing whatever. No.
Do you like 1980s action movies?
I feel like this is the beginning of an infomercial.
Do you like 1980s action movies? Well, Tango and Cash, it was made like 89, 90, like late 80s, early 90s, but it's the perfect 80s action movie. It's Sylvester Stallone and Kurt Russell as Tango and Cass are like two reckless cops that are partnered together. And, you know, framed for crimes and all kinds of stuff.
Wasn't there, like, a lot of movies like that during that time?
Oh, yeah.
There were just, like, three different, at least.
But this one is, like, the perfect example of that. Because it was made completely seriously. Completely with a straight face. But it's such a over-the-top, crazy movie that it almost becomes, like, a parody of that genre.
Oh, God.
It's just so much fun. Oh, and
Don't
I'm die. About to... murdered. Cool. I guess we're going to head back into town.
I have the Secret of Joyce Pirates, and I have Find Out the Offenders, and I have Tomb Raider.
What was the Joyce Pirates? Because I think I may have finished that.
Well, I finished that in one area. This is for who's looking. Look for Belkan Dagger. Defeat 10 upset sparks and 10 upset mutant sparks in the mining area.
Okay. Yeah, let's head over to the mining area and we can get that.
Did you? Can
out.
You check though? Because I think.
Can
I just want to make sure.
Can
you
I?
Have
in
the... I just want to make sure that there's not you're not gonna miss the quest.
Yeah. Oh no no! I finished that quest.
Okay, because I had a quest in that area before. And then. Like I'm doubling back. Whatever. Let's go over there.
Whatever.
How close are you to 39?
Not too far. I'm 80, about 79%. Yeah. I listen to a lot of bad movie podcasts. Like it's a lot of fun to.
Podcasts.
Yeah. There are. A lot of them are out of New York, but they have ones like How Did This Get Made, where they did one.
How Did This Get Made?
Yeah, they have episodes about like the Mega Shark and like those, like Sharknado, they have an episode on that.
I need to watch Sharknado still.
That's a fun one. We Hate Movies. The Flophouse is one of my personal favorites. They talk about the movies a little bit, but it's mostly just like weird... digressions and goofs and stuff like that.
Yeah.
But a lot of times it's like the chemistry of the hosts that make it so much fun. It's just like, you know, it's like right here talking about bad movies with friends. And so it's like, hey, I can't be watching bad movies while I drive, so I'll listen to people complain about them.
So that I never escape the bad movies.
Yeah. Food Fight is a uniquely bad movie. That is really a must be seen to be believed.
What is it about?
Food Fight. Hey, did you like Toy Story?
Yes.
You know, do you like movies where things come to life when like people go home? You know, like toys or.
I can see where this is going.
Yeah. How about if they were like brand mascots?
Oh God. I mean, what's the plot of that?
Did you see Casablanca?
Oh my God! Why?
Yeah, it's Charlie Sheen as Dex Dog Detective. He's like a McGruff crime-fighting dog who is a mascot of like some Raisin brand, he's a mascot of like some brand. Basically, the movie was conceived as like it'll be Toy Story, but we'll get like. You know, famous mascots like Mr. Clean and Charlie Tuna, and it's like, oh, we'll have these brands pay us to have their logos in this movie, and it's going to be a CG, beautiful. It'll be a beautiful CG movie, but they ran into some problems. You know, they only got like a couple brands to really, you know, put their products in, so. They didn't have any of the super, super famous mascots. And the other problem, their hard drive with all of the render data on it was stolen.
Oh, God.
So they had to basically restart the movie at like a fraction of the budget.
Oh, that's
sad. Which was not great anyway. And so the finished project looks real bad.
That's awful.
The computer animation makes Reboot look good.
The TV show?
Yeah. Like, Reboot doesn't give you wide awake nightmares.
Oh my god.
This might.
That doesn't sound appealing at all.
No, it's wonderful. You know what? It's a monster movie, but
I don't want to have wide awake nightmares.
Oh, that's fine. Everybody gets them.
This sum for the person who doesn't want to go through a haunted house for.
I can shut my eyes for a bad movie. I can't.
You can just keep walking. Close your eyes. Run into walls. Oh, people, yeah, monsters, yeah. Scary things, that's spiders.
Cool. Yeah.
Wide awake nightmares.
It's like, that doesn't sound appealing. Well, I'm in a haunted house, but you have to watch Food Fight, and we'll record a live podcast about it.
Which, I'll watch Food Fight if you go through a haunted house with a camera.
I mean, I'm probably going to have to do that anyway.
That's true. That's... Alright, I completed the quest, so...
Okay.
And it's actually about time that flew by.
Yeah, that was tons of fun. Maybe I better use a teleport scroll or something.
I'm at the Puff Tower, so I'm just going to use that. Wait, where do you want? Oh, okay. I'm going to go to...
I guess that's not that far.
I want to go to Port of Winds, because we'll get EXP, boost, and then we can just puff to wherever.
Yeah, that's a good idea. Ooh, but I'm a little low on health.
Don't die. Oh, make sure when you get there that you jump when you get to the top, because it'll just... Okay, yeah. I just say that because that's what happened to me.
We'll head back to Port of Winds... But yes, Corbala, if you want to talk about Food Fight and Tango and Cash in future podcasts,
you've
we can definitely
apparently
do that.
Found the right person.
Well, hey, you know, Tango and Cash, you know, people know that movie. It was not a huge hit like they had thought it was. It's a little bit obscure, but Food Fight, that is something that nobody really knows about.
I didn't know
and the
I
people
knew that
who do, it's like a Lovecraft nightmare. It's like,
Lovecraft,
yeah,
nightmare. None of these sound like things that are appealing.
I'm talking it up too much. You know,
you're doing the opposite.
I will link you to the trailer.
Oh God.
Okay. It's fine. You know, don't worry.
You learned about it through Oda.
Yes.
Spreading the terrible gospel.
I'm a thought maker.
I'll watch the trailer, and if it's not the worst thing I've ever seen in my entire life, and I'll post it on my Twitter.
No, it should be the opposite. If it is the worst thing you've ever seen.
Okay.
But okay.
That's fair.
See, it's one of those things where it's
like...
He
hasn't seen them!
Corbala, you should see it. I think the whole thing's on YouTube. Tango and Cash...
Bad when they allow the movie to stay on YouTube.
Or something like that, or even buy it. I highly recommend Tango and Cash. It is... It's the perfect 80s action movie, and I say that with
wasn't ironic. Lethal Weapon and
I mean Lethal Weapon, 48 Hours.
Yeah, there's a bunch of them. That was
this one
every
is
every movie I remember from that 80s era.
It's so over the top, it becomes like a parody of itself, but it's still straight face, so I love that a lot.
I usually watch really bad movies when it's 2 o'clock in the morning on a weekend, and I'm just I'm gonna stay up all night, and then I'll just I could just sit there and keep watching it going, this is so bad. Plus it's more funny at that point because everything's funny because you're really tired, and it's oh, this is great. And then in the morning I'm just why did I do that? That was not a reason to stay up until 4 in the morning.
Next time, make it Food Fight.
Yeah. Alright, thank you for joining us. Don't forget, there's a server maintenance today at 1500 server time.
Mm-hmm.
So have a great rest of your Wednesday.
Thank you for watching, folks, and catch us on Friday.
Bye.